season. Manchester United away, first game, new manager there, the eyes of the world on that match. Are you ready?
Yeah, I believe so. We've had a very good week's training so far and obviously worrying about ourselves. But yeah, all eyes are on Manchester United and obviously the situation that's been going on there through the summer and into the start of the season. So obviously all the focus will be on them, which suits us fine. You know, we can get on with our job and try and go up there and do the best we can.
There was a lot of eyes on you when you took over from Michael Laudrup here last year. It's going to be a slightly different situation on Saturday, isn't it? You could be the least photographed manager ever.
Yeah, be nice, wouldn't it? I wouldn't say that the focus when I took over was as much as it's going to be on obviously new manager at Manchester United. But no, it's part of the parcel. The big clubs attract the most attention. They've got, you know, the best players in the world play for these biggest clubs, and obviously managers as well, the most experienced and obviously considered the best quality of manager will always go to the bigger clubs. So yeah, it's great. All focus on them, and you know, we can go about our job and try and get on with it the best way we can.
Louis van Gaal seems to have made an immediate difference there, judging by the pre-season games. Do you expect that difference to be apparent?
Yeah, I think so. I think they've had a very positive pre-season, and you know, whenever you go to Manchester United, it doesn't matter what under what manager or obviously what sort of team that you play, the quality that they have, the strength that they have in depth, and it's always going to be a tough game for a club like ourselves. But again, you know, we got there with full confidence and had a good pre-season behind us, and make sure that we got there and try and put a good performance on.
They were vulnerable at home last season, lost a few games, lost to yourselves as well in the cup. Do you think that period is finished?
No, everyone's beatable. Everyone. It doesn't matter. Best teams in the world, you know, most consistent teams in the world are beatable. So on any given day, and things drop right for yourselves, and you know, you're at the top of your performance, and you know, you're on top of the opponents, and they're slightly off it, and then you always have the chance. So yeah, we got the belief that we'll win the game, and we've proven it, you know, time and time again since we've been in the Premiership that we can beat big clubs. So obviously we realise how difficult it'd be and how much more difficult it'd be considering how the moment they seem to be in. So but we don't consider it as a fear, we consider it as a challenge.
And looking at them already, do you see the influence of that new manager in the way they're playing?
Well, I think so, because you can obviously tell by the formations that they've been playing. So yeah, there's an instant influence, but obviously their players are playing well. They've had some very good results in pre-season, and I think when you consider he's been in for a short space of time, you can see the influence already coming through.
And as far as your squad's concerned, are you stronger than you were at the end of last season? You've had a fairly big turnover of players.
Yeah, I've said it for the last few weeks that I'd like to strengthen two or three more bodies to come in just to strengthen the squad in terms of the depth and obviously that added quality, which will help us, but that's what we're working hard to do right now, and hopefully we can get those bodies in before the transfer window closes. And it would be nice, obviously, when you're going up against teams like this who have strength and depth, you know, throughout the club. It's something for us to try and match in terms of that. So yeah, that's something that we're looking at.
Are you close to bringing in Federico Fernandez?
Yep, we've had good chats with him. A fee has been agreed with the clubs, and now just sorting out the personal details, and hopefully all being well, that he'll be coming over to have a medical as soon as possible.
This week?
Hopefully this week, yeah. Like I said, just a few details to be ironed out and sorted out, and obviously when that's all okay and the feedback comes back from that, then obviously he'll be over as soon as possible to have the medical.
But not in time for Saturday?
No, not in time for Saturday.
Tell me about him as a player. What are you getting?
Hopefully a very good player. You know, he's obviously brings that pedigree where he's been playing for Napoli and, you know, at the top level, and obviously for Argentina he played in the World Cup, and you know, the age that he's at is a very good age for us, and you know, the type of player that he is, he's a good size, very good footballer, and something that will suit Swansea City. And I think having spoke to, you know, himself and the agent, the type of player that we try and identify to bring in here and are ones that add quality to the squad, and he definitely will do that.
You've been linked with a few other players as well. Are you still looking to add to the squad?
Yep, as I just said before, you know, two or three more bodies would be nice in certain areas, and that's what we're trying to identify, and hopefully we can do some business.
Timothy Collins-Zizak, is that a player you're interested in?
There's been about a million names. You could probably go through a whole list that's on your book that probably we've been linked to. But no, we have our targets that we want, the areas that we want to obviously prioritise and try and get in, and obviously we will work hard on trying to get those names in, and if possible at all, so that's what we'll be looking at.
You've seen other players leave as well recently. Pablo Hernandez, you confirmed today, has gone.
Yep.
He was a player that you very much seemed to believe in last season.
Yeah.
What's changed?
No, nothing's changed. I spoke to Pablo, had some good discussions with him at the end of last season and obviously at the start of this season when he came back in for pre-season. So, no, had some very good chats. I think it comes down to more the player himself, you know. Very much wanted him to be here, but I think he was in his last year of his contract. He wanted a longer contract than we would be possible to offer. And obviously he had that longer term contract offered to him from abroad. And he felt that it was the right decision for him and his family. And, you know, when that situation happens between a manager and a player, when the player's thinking that way, I always feel that having those experiences and spoke to players in those situations before, is that you're better off letting them to do that, you know, rather than keeping a player here that doesn't really want to be here, doesn't want to be part of it and won't buy into the situation you're in if they're thinking about other things. So that's the situation with Pablo.
A lot of the Spanish players then have left. Was that a conscious decision? Was there a cosy club there that needed to be broken up?
No, Michu, Chico, Pablo were all in the same situation where, as I just talked about, in terms of they came to me, spoke to me, we had good discussions, got on very well with all of them, and we just came to a mutual agreement between the three of us. That it was, well, obviously, they had the discussions at the same time, but separately, but that they wanted to move on to other things and try new challenges, and that I wasn't going to step in their way because, you know, like I just said, there's no point in having a player that doesn't want to be here. I'm only interested in players that want to play for Swansea, so that's the situation with them. In terms of the rest of it, is I have to make decisions whether I want players here or not, and for me, I don't care what nationality you are. All I care about is the football and what you do as a footballer. And I want the players that I feel are best for me to take this club forward. So that's how I do it.
You've kept Wilfred Boney here. How vital is it that he stays here for this season?
Yeah, we said all along how important, you know, Wilfred is to us and what a great season he had last season. And that we feel that, you know, the way that we're working right now and as the season progresses, hopefully we'll see an even better Wilfred Boney. And obviously speak to him a lot, you know, I speak to all the players very much, you know, I've that hands on with them, and Wilfred's very, very focused, very committed in training and looking forward to the new season.
No offers, no interest in him?
Zero offers have come into the club, and you know, there's obviously rumours and speculation as there is with a lot of our players, but no, in terms of offers and stuff, nothing at all.
When you look at the strength of your squad, Gary, compared to others in the league, you had a difficult, perhaps a bit of a wobble last season, then you pulled away at the end. Are you confident this will be a more relaxed season for the club?
Yeah, I wouldn't say relaxed because I'm not a relaxed type of person. So the players know that, you know, I mean business. The players mean business themselves. And yeah, like I said, we need to add strength in depth to our squad, which we've made very clear. But there's no guarantees in this league. It can be anything, you know. If you don't do the right things, if we don't approach the games right, then we can be in trouble. But if we do it right, the quality that we have within the squad, the way that we play football, the way that we approach games, then, you know, we'll be more than fine. But I think it's, you know, it's the day-to-day basis that I approach it on, and, you know, each game as it comes. And I know a lot of people say that, but that is truly how we focus and make sure that we get ourselves right as possible for the games. And you do need that little bit of the green to go for you at times. But, you know, I'm more than confident in this group that they've got the quality to do well.
And at the top end of the table, who do you see as the title contenders? Who do you think is going to win it?
I'm not sure who will win it, but you can. It's the same. It seems to be the same every season in terms of you probably get the top six that really are competing. And I think it just seems the way that it's going, and you know, in with this league and the money situations, that these teams will probably go further and further away from the rest of the group. And the kind of two leagues that you find with, you know, the top six and the rest is, the gap will probably become bigger because of the money and the power that they have, the amount of quality players and the best players in the world that they're able to attract. So I think you'll see more of a divide the way that it's going right now. But I still think it's a fantastic league. It's the best league in the world. It's the most entertaining, most watched. And in terms of who will win it, who knows? You just never know. Everyone was beating everyone last year. I think the league, I think in terms of topping the table, changed 25 times, if I'm right, or around that figure. So that happened last year. Who's to say that won't happen again?
Gary, great to see you. We were chatting with Lee Trundle a few days ago, and he said that he felt that you were under less pressure now than perhaps you were at the tail end of last season, because obviously, you know, confirmed in the job and everything, and he felt that you seem just a lot more relaxed about things, although you say that you're not a relaxed person. I mean, has he got it wrong? Is his perspective wrong on you for this season?
Well, it depends how many times I'm sat in here talking talking to all of you like that. I'm relaxed. I believe in myself, you know. I've always believed in myself. And the way I go about things, and I said to you before, in terms of I think I'd struggle in this position if I didn't have a plan in my head. I have a clear plan of what I want to do, and okay, that can adjust in certain aspects throughout that journey, but it's a clear plan of what I want to try and get to and get my team to, and that's what I'm focusing on. And I think the players understand that. I think they can see it in me that I believe in what I'm doing, and I think when you show that to them, that, you know, generally 9 times out of 10 they'll come with you and want to be part of it. And obviously the quality and everything that you give to them has to be right, but that's what I'm trying to do. And in terms of relaxed, I don't know, there's no one, I said to you before, no one puts me under pressure more than myself. So in terms of that, I can deal with myself a lot better. So yeah, I'm more relaxed about it. But obviously with the, I realise how important it is for me this season and the team and the club and everything, with the whole how it looks from the outside, that we do well.
Does it feel different though, the fact that, you know, forgive the term, it's not a nice term, I know, but that, you know, you're not on probation anymore, this is your job.
Yeah.
How does it feel now? I mean, in so many ways, I suppose, you no longer need to prove yourself to anybody in terms of getting the job, but I suppose now you need to prove about keeping the job.
Yeah, you're totally right, and the difference is now is I'm the manager. It's as simple as that. The players know that. The players have been very good, very understanding on the situation. I think at the end of last season, it was, obviously I was a player, and then, you know, you change to the interim manager as the title, and, you know, you still have that, you know, players will fight for you because of the character that I was, but in terms of thinking to themselves, nailing down places and fighting for the right to be at the team and still be at the club, it wasn't really my decision at that point, you know, whereas now they know that it's my decision that's final. And I think once you have that side of it with you to back you up, I think players do react differently to you, do look at you differently, and albeit I still be myself, and they understand that. Is the factor is that now I'm the manager, that's the way it will be.
So with the people who've come and gone over the summer, and I mean, as you say, you still want to make some signings as well, how would you describe the complexion of Garry Monk's Swansea City for this season?
We'll see on the games that we play. But no, I'm just trying to do the best I can, do the what I feel is right for the team and for the players themselves, get them as fit and sharp as possible. With the way that we play, we have to be Swansea City. We have to be what we've been in the past, but better, you know, because each season it gets tougher and tougher and the league gets harder and harder. Everyone's fighting that little bit harder because of, obviously, the rewards that can come with this league. But we have to make sure we keep our identity, which is something I've preached massively since I've come back in this pre-season, and something that we believe in as a club, but also the players that believe in and the new ones that come in have to buy into it. And obviously there'll be tweaks in terms of what I do in terms of styles and stuff like that, but the principles always have to be what we are, which is a possession passing team, try and be attacking and obviously entertaining, but ultimately trying to get the right results.
Graham touched on it, the fact that, you know, there was a strong finish to the end of last season. It would have been nice to have carried that momentum on into the start of this. I mean, is there any way that you can do that? Is there a sense amongst the players that there is an element of that left over to take it, particularly into this trip?
You can do, yeah, I understand. But obviously with new personnel and stuff as well, the feeling, I think what you have to do at this point is create the group that feels they're together and that they're working in a good way and that they're working together and it's a team, it's not individuals or anything like that. And that's what I tried to create through pre-season. You have ups and downs, you have certain days it works, it doesn't. But I think in a whole, and obviously I know you'll speak to a couple of the players later, they'll be able to tell you better than me, but I feel that the group's very much together and very much fighting in the same direction, which is another big part of what we are.
Yeah, finally from me, we had the chance to speak with Gilfie yesterday, who's obviously delighted to be back. He feels that he can bring something back into Swansea now as a more experienced player, having been at Spurs, obviously that Premier League experience at a high level. Do you feel you need a little bit more of that before the transfer window closes, that Premier League experience?
Yeah, I think so, but more the quality in terms of, you know, the depth of the squad. You know, you don't want to just bring anyone in for the sake of it. You want someone in that can compete and do well and challenge people for places, and that's what it's about. And obviously we're a few numbers short in certain areas, so it'd be nice to try and get them in and get the feel for the way that we work before. Ideally it would have been great to have them in a few weeks ago, but things dictate that's the way it is. But if we can get them in before now, the sooner we can get them in, the better we can start working with them and them to get the understanding of how we work and also for them to settle in better.
Best of luck. Really
cheers, Fran.
Gary, hello there.
Hey.
How are you doing? You talk about the squad bringing extra players in. I guess some people will say you've lost some quality, haven't you? Michu, Vaughan, Davis, Chico. That's a lot of quality players that you've lost. And I guess some pundits will say you might struggle without that quality.
I don't agree with that. We've brought in quality to replace that. If you're talking Pablo, then Gilfie's come in. If you're talking Michu, and obviously Gomez has come in. I can't remember the other ones you said. I lost Chico, obviously. Chico's come in, obviously Fernandez is now coming in. So in terms of replacing them, yeah, we've replaced them with quality. So yeah, obviously the left back is a situation. Obviously we're lucky in the sense that we already have a, you know, Neil Taylor with us, and the two of them, there was never much between him and Ben Davis. So we're lucky in that sense. But obviously now I need to bring someone in that can push tails and obviously fight for that left back spot, which is obviously an area that I've identified as well. But again, it's down to personnel and quality of what we can bring in. So in terms of what you're saying, a lot have gone the other way, but we also brought in some good players as well. Don't forget that.
Can I throw another name at you? You've been linked with millions, as you say. Benjamin Stambouli at Montpellier.
Never heard of him.
What about De Guzman? Is there any move for De Guzman dead now?
No. The situation was we obviously made contact with Jono and his agent. You know, once they were still in the World Cup at the time, and obviously made inquiries, but you know, from his side of it, they decided that they wanted to keep their options open and see what else was out there and not give a definitive answer. And for me at that point, I need to move on. I need to get my squad together. I need to make sure that, you know, everyone's on board that wants to be on board. And for me, look, the door's never closed on anyone. But in terms of that right now, no, there's no situation with Jonathan.
We're talking about the Spanish players who've left. What about Jose Cañas? He's been linked with Elche.
Yeah.
Moved there.
No, you know, again, I spoke to Cañas, you know, at the start of the season, towards the end of last season as well. And for me, it was clear it wasn't going to be part of my plans. It's as simple as that. You have to be honest with players. I said it right away, I'd be honest with the players. And for me, the way that I want to go forward with the team and a way of playing and being that way is he wasn't part of the plans. And he understood that. And obviously, that's the situation now. He's trying to find another club. And obviously, we're trying to help him find another club. And that's the situation.
And just finally on you, I mean, an extraordinary journey that you've been on for the last 10 years. And when you think back to where you were 10 years ago, making your debut against Northampton in a 2-0 defeat, and here you are about to walk out as a manager at Old Trafford, what do you make of it?
It's not bad. It's all right. No, it's something I'm really looking forward to. But honestly, I don't focus. I don't focus on myself. Focus on the players. Focus on making sure that I deliver to the best quality that I can. The details of what in training, I really don't think about the bigger picture. I think about now and how I can get those players the best and what's best for them and my team that are around me, you know, in terms of the staff. Instead of focusing on myself, of course, I have to be right, but so I push myself. But in terms of that, maybe I'll think about that after the game, but I don't really care. All I care is that we got there and put a performance on, and then maybe I'll think about, you know, the achievements that we've done or anything like that. But right now, I haven't achieved anything as a manager. Obviously, early days for me and trying to learn the process and coming up against these types of managers, these arenas, will be great, but it's not my focus. My focus is on us and the players because they mean the most to the club, they mean the most to me, so it's important that I get the best out of them.
Can you learn anything from going up against Van Gaal over a 90-minute period stood there next to him in the technical areas?
Yeah, of course you can. You can understand, you know, how their team play against you, what you can do to try and affect their formations, and if they change it, what you do to change to them and stuff like that. And you don't always do it at the time, but it's something that you can reflect on afterwards, or if you happen to see it in the game that you can change something or a detail that you can give to a player. So you're constantly looking at the game, analysing the game throughout the 90 minutes. So yeah, you learn a lot, and obviously when you reflect back on it afterwards as well, you pick up on what you would do next time, or if it was a similar situation, what you would do, what you would change. So you're constantly doing that.
Hi, Gary. Dennis from Danish Television. You say these players that were key players on the line but wanted to leave the club. To which degree did you try to talk to them to stay here?
No, I spoke to all of them. Really wanted to keep them. They're quality players, all of them. And made it clear that they were part of my plans and going forward. But, you know, this happens many times in many seasons over every single club. You know, players have an idea in their head and you try and talk them out of certain situations because you try and show them the future that can be here for them. And obviously with the league that we're in, the Premier League, for me, is the best league. But sometimes players want that for different reasons. Like I said with Pablo, in terms of, I don't think it was so much he really wanted to go, but it was more hit the security for himself and his family. And in terms of his age and where he was at, you know, in terms of he wanted 3 years or 4 years contract, we couldn't offer him that. You know, we just financially and everything couldn't offer him that deal. So I think that made his mind up in terms of that. And then obviously meet you, the season that he had last season, obviously I think he felt that he just wanted a new challenge and to move to another club. So I wanted all of them to stay in terms of the three of that we're talking about. So yeah, but you can never, once a player's mind's set and you talk to him and then the feedback is that they still want to go, and then you're better off just letting the player go.
Question from Jonathan Hughes. course, Chico Flores is being reunited with Michael Laudrup in Qatar. Any plans on calling Laudrup to hear if he wants any more of his old players back?
I don't dictate what happens. I just concentrate on my players, and obviously our players are very good. You know, we've got some very good quality players at our team, and they always attract attention from a number of teams. And you know, my job is to make sure that they see the future here and plan with them, and that they see the way that we want to go, and then hopefully that's enough for them to want to stay here. But the players that don't want to, like I just mentioned, and it comes to that situation, and you have to find a mutual agreement that suits the club first, because we're the one that's in the power where it's our player. If someone wants them, then it has to be on our terms. So that's the good part for us. But eventually, if you get to that point, then it's okay.